Where are you going?
Who needs episode 64? Hey, it's a pleasure to meet you. Be safe out here, my guy. I'm gonna go find something to eat. All right, guys, what is up? It is your least favorite moto vlogger, Brian636, coming to you live with Hood Eats episode 64. Today, we're in a city that I haven't been to before, but is so long overdue for Hood Eats for so many reasons. We are in the east side of Birmingham, Alabama. Today, I'm on my OG, my ride or die, my 2003 ZX6r. I love you, baby. She came down here with me as well as my Dyna. I rode the Dyna last night. Things got a little interesting. But today, we are pretty much just going to the east side to a notorious part of Birmingham called Gate City / East Lake. There's still some really big housing projects there and apparently a lot of good street vending and good little local barbecue. We're in the south. We're doing barbecue. I don't want to run my mouth too much, guys, so let's just get into this. These guys are all not coming with me. I'm actually going to split off from the group. These guys are all going into downtown, and they're gonna head south from here, and I'm gonna continue to head east. So let's go ahead and get into episode 64.
This is a pretty crazy Airbnb.
What? When did you get this? I thought you had it 03-04.
I've had this for like a year.
Oh, it's beautiful.
I just don't bring it out of town since people go crash into it.
Yeah, yeah. That's the problem with having nice bikes. Everyone wants to crash into them. Damn.
The jet coming in, landing.
So, like I said, we'll ride with these guys for, I don't know, a whole 2 seconds. My buddy Cody from Nashville here at the gas station with the boys, and then we're gonna go do our own thing. The old Chevy on some 22s, 24s. Whoa! You come in peace? What'd you say? Let you get a ride? I don't need no nuts grabbing onto the back of me. I always find that a little odd when guys ask for a ride. What do you think? We'll go ahead and grab some gas, I suppose. Man, look at how cheap gas is in the south. $3.29. It's like almost $5 just for unleaded up in Chicago. Put some of that good 93 in this thing. No, I don't want to sign up for a reoccurring receipts. What the? Dude, I'm so excited to do Birmingham. This is gonna be a good one, guys. Oh, look at this. We can play an old game of circles here. This was a really good way to learn control on circles. I'll show you what I'm talking about. We'll go in, we'll lap the first cone, we'll lap the second cone, lap it wide, lap it tight. It's a really good way to just control your circles. So we're gonna wrap it tight. Now we're gonna come in, wrap the other one. And then we're gonna go ahead and go wide around both. Tight. Wide. Tight.
One more chance left.
You gotta get on with me. Come on. Come on. Your head's gonna break after you get off the thing. If you don't want me to, I won't. Come on. I won't stand up.
I won't.
Just around the gas station. Just around the gas station. I can't wait to talk to you guys a little bit about this place, this crazy little coop town in the south. What? We're having too much fun for it to be a weekday. Hey, not my problem.
All right, guys, sorry to interrupt this Hood Eats down in Birmingham, Alabama. I just wanted to let you know this is your absolute last time to get entered into the ZX6R giveaway going on over on my Patreon. We pulled a winner for this on September 30th, and every dollar you pledge in between now and then is an entry into winning this beautiful bike. It's the best way to support my channel. YouTube absolutely hates what we're doing over here, but you know we love the 636s, and we're going to keep doing this. So check out the link down in the description, and let's get back to this Hood Eats down in the south. I love y'all.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. I think this is where I say goodbye to the pack. Fair winds.
Where are you going?
Hood Eats, episode 64. We're going to the east side. I'll see you guys in a little bit. See you later, buddy. See you later, pack. And hello and welcome to Hood Eats, episode 64. Look at this. Just huge, huge southern mansions like that just boarded up. That is unfortunately just the norm here in Birmingham, Alabama. The more I've drove around, the more I've realized that that is just the current state of this city. North, south, east, and west side are all in, I don't want to say decrepit states, but definitely a lot of abandoned buildings, a lot of old homes that are just boarded up. Now, Birmingham's story is a little bit different from most of the other cities I've done on Hood Eats, whether it's St. Louis or Detroit or some of the neighborhoods within Chicago, because it is just that. It is a very different city than those Midwest Rust Belt cities. But first things first, I gotta get to where we're going. That's Gate City. Had a pretty big fire that happened here. Holy crap. Look at that, man. Like, literal mansions. Like, these are million-dollar homes in Chicago and most other cities in the U.S. These things are just in a state of decay. Crazy. I'm excited to talk to you guys about Birmingham's history and why it's so overdue. This is actually the second most dangerous city in the U.S., second only to St. Louis, Missouri, which I know I talked about in the multiple episodes of Hood Eats that I've done down in St. Louis. I think I've done two. And what I'm going off of is the homicides per capita, which means, you know, your total population divided by the total number of homicides that year. And if we do that in a place like Birmingham, it is unfortunately the second most dangerous city in America. And the more we're going to ride around in this, the more you're going to realize why that is a reality here. Poverty is just, it's different, man. Oh, no. Oh, no, guys. Hi, Moomoos. I got some baby ones. Hey, all the lambs. Hi, guys. Oh, sheep. They're not lambs. Sheep. What's up, sheep? I hope you guys have a last good ride on the highway. I'm sorry your fate just landed you this way. You too, Moomoos. See you later, cows. Destiny just had a different thought for those guys, I guess. Man, is it starting to rain or what? It is, and I'm gonna have to start clearing the lens. I wouldn't even know it's raining, thanks to my misguided windbreaker. Truly waterproof. Not a sponsored ad either. Over the railroad tracks, and we are gonna go ahead and turn into the infamous Gate City housing projects down here in Birmingham. Facilities and places like this were shut down in the early 2000s in Chicago, but apparently there's still quite a few residents living down here. Pretty crazy, man. This is the most dangerous section of the second most dangerous city in the country, man. You can feel it, man. Now, I think it doesn't come as a surprise of why a housing project might be. What up? I'm here for the big ride out. No, 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 the 205 black guys? Yeah, they're putting it on tonight. Yeah, yeah, yeah. There's a pretty big bike scene here in Birmingham, Alabama. I'm just floating through. I'm from Chicago, man. I'm just enjoying myself. Where, this is Gate City? This is the projects. Yeah? Everyone's pretty friendly around here? That's cool.
I ride a Banshee.
Oh, you got a 350? A little Banshee? Right. Those are bad bikes, man. Those things are going up in value.
Hey, mine's in the roof, but I got it switched lower.
Yeah, you got the engine built too? Damn. Yeah, those Banshees are expensive now, man. I'll tell you what. Oh, I see your half helmet. Yeah, you're not kidding. You really do got a Banshee.
Oh,
you got a street glide? I got an FXDL. Man, stop playing with me. You stay over here in Gate City?
Daughter up right quick.
Okay. Yeah. Let me see. Yo, you got drag slicks on it?
Nah, actually, they were mud tires.
They're just down to the f***ing cords. Is this you swinging it? You gonna swing it? I already know. God damn it. Is that your name?
Yeah. Avery Leroy.
Avery Leroy. Good southern man. What do you think about it? Is this one of the more dangerous areas in Birmingham?
It depends on what you call danger, but yeah, it is. It's, you can go to the worst place in the world.
Yep. Find good people. Ain't that the truth? This is my Harley.
Oh, you walking that thing, man.
That's you. That's me. That's little old me. I go all over the country, all over the world doing Hood Eats like this. I go to neighborhood restaurants, everything like that. And I talk about the history of the place and stuff. So it's pretty cool, man, coming through the Appalachian Mountains and figuring out, like, Birmingham's one of the lowest valleys in the Appalachians. Well, it's really good to meet you, my guy, for real. Hopefully I'll see you out there tonight. Ain't that the truth? You can go to the worst place in the world and find some real nice people. I like that. In Gate City, Birmingham, baby. Oh. Be safe out here, my guy. I'm gonna go find something to eat.
Cool.
All right, brother. Hit it up.
This is crazy down here. I'll give it that. Everyone wants to see wheelies.
What's up, little guys?
Everyone wants to see wheelies, but from an outsider looking at it, pretty sad situation. Just because anyone who lives in Chicago or has lived in Chicago when our housing projects were there and, you know, why and when they got demolished, you know the reason that they did, you know? It's because they're a giant failure. When you lump, you know, poverty with poverty with poverty, it just leads to desperation, and it's just not a good situation. Lots of Kias with broken out windows down here. Love to see it, love to see it. Birmingham's probably still getting control of that. Chicago's just now starting to get control of that, so. And this isn't just a little housing project, man. This is pretty big. What do we got here? Damn. All the cars and tires. Is this your collection? Wow. You're a cowboy? What's up, man, cowboy? I'm Brian. Hey, pleased to meet you. This is quite the car collection you got here, man. What's that?
That's my Alabama
tent. The Alabama tent. It'll protect you from the rain and whatnot? Wow. How long have you been down here for?
Gate City?
Yeah. You're the mayor of Gate City?
49 years looking at the
picture. Wow. Holy crap. I'm with the mayor. I'm from Chicago, Illinois. Hey, a pleasure to meet you.
You know, I got a niece living in Chicago.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What part?
You know, where, God, would it be,
There's Bridgeport, Bridgeview.
That's
Bridgeview?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, she's out in the west suburbs. This is pretty impressive, man. You mind if I get a picture?
Damn. When you call 911, Jesus.
Call 911, Jesus. Wow. This is quite the collection you got there here, though, man. That's pretty cool. The mayor of Gate City, I like it.
Where you live?
We got a building right here beside the store, right beside the funeral home. My man, he got like a lot of dirt bikes and shit. We ride side by side. He just went about a screenshot.
Yeah?
We got a haul too. Cause we on tour by bike life. I mean, we ride four-wheelers.
Your bike life for real, yeah, I see. He got bikes over there?
Yeah.
Maybe I'll go check it out. It's straight down here to the right?
When you come down to the south side, make it right.
Cool. Shit. I'm going to go check it out.
You see my throat right there.
Okay.
Pull up.
Cool.
I know them kids that you bring catch fish.
Yeah.
I raised them here in the insulation building.
What's the typical fish out here? Catfish?
Cat, bass, crappie.
Okay. Wow. You've been in Birmingham your whole life?
Not my whole life.
Okay.
I'm 78 years old.
You're 78?
And I work 3 jobs.
Wow. Hold what on. Are you drinking, a cold 45?
That's what I drink.
Good man. You mind if I wet my whistle?
Hell no.
Gotta open it all the way, huh?
Hey,
nothing like a Colt 45. Mm-mm. All right, man. Mayor, you be safe out here.
Yeah, when you come out sometime, holler at me.
I will, man. You be safe, huh?
All right, guys, what would Hood Eats be without a little bit of history? And Birmingham, Alabama has a lot of it. Birmingham, Alabama is located in one of the lowest valleys in all of the Appalachian Mountains. Now, unlike other valleys in the Appalachian Mountains, Birmingham, Alabama is super rich in coal deposits and iron. So much so that people from all over the South basically started to flood this town as somewhat of a gold rush. The population quickly grew over 400,000 people. And homes, industry, education systems, taxes, and basically just a whole community to support these people was established here. Now, just like with other Hood Eats, these industries in this town began to get outsourced, unfortunately, and American workers were really left to still suffer.
They took our jobs!
So as these industries in the 60s, 70s, and especially the 80s began to get outsourced outside of the country, Birmingham began to lose jobs. And what comes with job loss? Same old story. Like I said again, desperation sets in. People turn to gangs. People turn to crime. If you got, you know, two hungry kids at home and you're hungry yourself and you're a father, those kids and you are going to eat by any means, legal or not. And if you don't have the means to leave the city or your housing complex or whatever that might be, you're going to turn to crime, man. It is what it is. You're gonna eat. Birmingham, Alabama has lost
over 55% of its population, as it's just over 200,000 residents now. Now, what happens when over half your population leaves the city? Well, the people leave, but the buildings and the infrastructure and a lot of the other things, they just don't. So that's where you see some of these boarded up houses. This is where you see some of these foreclosed businesses. This is, you know, it's just not a good situation for anyone, because abandoned buildings can be used for crime and anything else. Now, like I said at the beginning of this video, this is the second most violent place in the whole country. Now, what are we basing that off of? That's what we're basing this off of, murders per capita. So that means there was 144 murders here in Birmingham with a population of just over 200,000 people. Now, if you divide those two numbers together, that's how the FBI basically ranks the country's most dangerous cities. For every 100,000 citizens in Birmingham every year, 55.4 of them will become a victim of a homicide. This makes Birmingham, Alabama, the second most violent city, only second to St. Louis, Missouri, which we already know is a super just crazy ass place.
What's up, buddy? Damn. He's on attack mode.
Hey.
What's up, man? I'm Brian.
I'm Powell, bro.
Good to meet you, man. The mayor says you guys been riding bikes around here since you're this tall.
Yeah, man.
That's cool, man. You live in Gate City your whole life?
Yeah.
Fuck yeah. And this is like your little garage right on the outskirts, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
You ride Banshees too?
I ride them, but he got them.
Okay. Yeah, man. What's that, a little slingshot?
Oh, yeah.
Slingshot, dirt bike.
You rode that something from Chicago?
No. I got a Sprinter van. I got this and the Harley with me, and I've been down here riding for a couple days.
You know how you cruise on your hoe. Ooh, that boy ride that big.
Yeah.
That's the one you got down?
That's a big girl, yeah.
He said that's a big girl.
Yeah. 954s, 636s, whatever. That was in Tokyo a couple weeks ago.
How long it took you for that?
I've been riding my whole life, probably just as long as you've been riding, man.
You can ride anything like that?
Probably not the slingshot. I don't do a lot of three-wheelers.
Dirt bike?
Oh, yeah.
While it's lit?
Right now.
He said right now. Go get that dirt bike.
All right, where's it at?
Back down in front of that sling inside that rim.
We got an Electric Star 450. Ooh, and it's a Kickstart grill, huh? This thing's hard to do, man, because the back tire on this is slick. Oh my God!
Yeah.
You ain't got no life on it.
That's why I was like, you ride dirt bike, goddamn, I wasn't.
Oh yeah, if you can wheelie a Harley or a big sport bike, you can always wheelie a dirt bike.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cool. Yeah, man, it's just that rear brake control. You know what I mean?
What time we getting out tomorrow? I'm popping out. What time?
2 p.m.
2 p.m.
Yup. Man, it just started pouring.
Yeah.
Holy hell.
Snap
over a
couple
pigeons
by the bike. I know, right?
Well, I'm gonna get to this barbecue spot in case it does close at 6, just to make sure. Thanks for letting me ride your bike.
All right, man.
Pleasure meeting you. I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Yeah.
Cool.
Birmingham, Alabama. All right, guys, we're heading to this barbecue spot off of First Ave. It says it's open until 9 p.m. I hope it is. Those guys told me it's already closed, but I'm going to listen to the internet and not just them, although I do want to believe them. So let's go check it out. You know what's really crazy is when you're looking around out here, you would not think you're in a metropolitan area. It looks pretty rural when we're going through some of the neighborhoods outside of Gate City. It looks like we're in the mountains, but we're in Birmingham proper, one of the, you know, biggest cities in Alabama, the second biggest city in all of Alabama. This southern poverty is a little bit different than our inner city poverty too. Like, the houses are just in really rough shape, a lot of them, but man, the people couldn't be any more friendly. Look at them waving at me. What the heck? You don't get that in Chicago. That is a real thing down here, man. Southern hospitality, southern, you know, friendliness. Like, this is crazy. I've never been somewhere where people are nicer to me so far.
Please be open, this isn't a good time. Saturday, Friday, 10:30 to 9 p.m. You guys open?
Guess not.
Guess we're going to have seafood at the gas station.
Mm. All right, this barbecue spot is closed, so we are going to head over to the seafood spot over by that gas station and hopefully not get some seafood. But if I got to eat some seafood, I guess I'm going to have to eat some freaking seafood. Absolutely soaking wet. Check it out. Let's pull in here.
To be riding this thing.
You're on fire.
I know. Not if I don't get a little pull of that, I won't. What is this? What do we got? Some Grey Goose? You mind if I take them?
No, just open your mouth. Don't go motherfucker, put your
I won't
on
do
you.
I won't do that. I ain't got none.
Hey, you good, bro.
Yeah.
Hey, look, I don't want you to get killed because you took some of that shit.
Nom, 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 nom. God damn. Hey, this is strong.
Stay in, bro. Be
all careful, right, man. Stay dry. So Birmingham is this shit. I love this place.
Man, that motherfucker lighter.
It's light?
It's light. The way you put that thing back?
Oh, it's about 450 pounds.
Oh.
You want to try to pick it up?
Hell no.
Oh. I think I'm moving to Birmingham, man. I like it here.
Yeah.
I like it.
How long you been here?
2 days. I tried to go to the roadside barbecue down the street. They're closed. It says they're open till 9. So I guess I'm getting seafood at the gas station. I'm going to full time later. I'll have the Philly steak fries.
Philly steak fries?
Yeah.
All the way?
Why the hell not? How are you doing? $12.09. I'm gonna stop and chill for a second, guys.
What's wrong with it? It's soaking wet.
It looked good.
He just doesn't like the rain much. You know, it starts getting water in the air box. And yeah. No, that's all good. I got some Philly cheesesteak fries to wait it out. That'll soak up the water.
Episode 64. So far, so good, guys. Just a little bit wet.
Meeting all types of good friends down here in Birmingham, huh?
Philly cheese fries look really good. I got them without mushrooms, but I got them with the green peppers and the onions, so I don't know. You know me, I can't do a lot of spicy shit though, so we're gonna see about this one, boys. Looks like Sloppy Joe. Kind of spicy, guys, kind of spicy.
I gotta say, as not dry as my helmet is, this thing is on fire. This is literally really good, but it's super spicy. Chili powder is pretty rough. You know me, muy gringo, muy, muy gringo. Can't do much, but I'm about full, boys. Someone come get my leftovers.
Yes, sir. Thanks, brother. Wet. Wet, wet. The roads are dangerous when it just rains like this.
How far you got to go?
Out to the west side of Birmingham. I'm staying on the west side. Yeah, I'm probably just going to jump on, what is that, 20? Yup. You stay out here in Gay City?
Yeah, I stay
up over
there.
Oh, okay, cool. I'm from Chicago, so I don't get down here too much. I like Birmingham, though, man. That's a pretty cool place.
Yeah, we got all kind of shit going on there, man.
Yeah, all types of big city stuff here. I'm not looking forward to getting on the highway on this, though. This is not going to be fun, man. This southern hospitality is a real thing, man. He knows that I'm not from here. Tell me how to get back to the highway, making sure I get there safe. Dude, you would never, never get that in Chicago. I promise.
Go, man.
Yep. The hell is the package store? Oh, it's like a liquor store. Woo, man, I am getting rained on, man. This is rough. By any standard, this is rough. Man, I gotta run my GPS. Oh, hell no. Dude, what is up with stray dogs on Hood Eats lately? Jesus. I thought he was running at me at first. Well, I know I gotta go west, so I should probably get on 20 west. What do you guys think? See if I can clutch up in the rain? Second gear? Waiting out the rain under a bridge. Typical biker stuff. What do you guys think? Let's hit the half pipe. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god!
That could end really bad, man.
Oh! Oh my god, dude. I literally just entertain myself and make myself laugh at times. What the hell? I got ADD. Damn, dude. Hoodie, episode 64. Who would have ever thought we'd be in Birmingham, Alabama, in the deep south? How's it going? 20 west to exit 20, huh? All right, let's head back to the west side of Birmingham
and hopefully wrap up this
wet but fun Hood Eats, man. Gate City, Birmingham, Alabama. Birmingham, Alabama is a really cool story, man. I really do find a lot of intrigue in the Appalachian Mountains and, you know, the culture that is surrounding a lot of these cities in Appalachia. And Birmingham is a product of just that. It's a product of the mountains. So basically, it's a product of, you know, the natural resources that exist here. The coal, the iron, you know, mine, factories, all that went up here in droves. And it's just sad. It's sad. It's the same old story, man. It really is. Different industries in different cities. Jesus, I almost got pulled into the rut. Different industries in different cities, but it's the same old story of outsourcing, undercutting, and the American people and American workers in big and little towns pretty much getting left to fend for themselves, man. It really is the same old story. Just so you got assholes like me that can come and ride wheelies in your city and talk a little bit about the history. All right, guys, as I wrap up on episode 64, I really do just want to take a second to genuinely thank you. You, the subscriber, the person watching this video. Like, I really don't say it enough, but I appreciate you guys who watch the videos, who like them, who comment, who do all this stuff. Like, I feel like, you know, if you've even watched just half of the 64 episodes of Hood Eats, or, you know, even one-tenth of my 600-something videos, like, you know me pretty well. So I just want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart. You guys know what to do. Like, comment, subscribe. Birmingham, can we not be the second most violent place in the whole U.S.? You guys are so awesome. Put the guns down. Respect life. As always, is your least favorite moto vlogger, Brian636, signing out from Birmingham, Alabama, Gate City, with the mayor. I love you guys. I'm out of here. Peace.